What's up, guys? I am back to bring you your recap on Love and Hip Hop Hollywood, season 5, episode 14, and it is titled Oops, She Did It Again. And this episode began, my God, with Monice and Mr. Ray discussing about the breakup that AD happened to do via text and or social media. And I feel like we've given AD so much credit and so much respect, but I believe this is their second breakup on this show, my God. And for AD to be deemed as the more mature, respectful, honorable one because of all the messiness that happens to come from Monice, my God, I personally feel like that AD is being messy in this situation. First and foremost, why would you break up with her via text? Why would you also post on social media? And then we can't forget last season, AD getting caught up with two girls dancing in front of her and one behind her, my God, at the club, and Monice seeing all of that. So I do love how supportive Mr. Ray was in this moment, because Monice shared about their issues, their problems. She said they were working on it and was going to therapy. So my thing is, whenever there are issues and someone is being proactive and trying to work through it, also go to therapy, I have to commend Monice, because one thing she said that was so important is all relationships go through things, my God. So I am a tad bit confused if they are going through therapy. It does seem like Monice is being productive, progressive, and changing. Why AD would go the messy route. Next, let's address this whole nighttime video live, Instagram live situation that Akbar had Tierra end. And I'm wording it that way because, as stupid as Tierra Marie is, I do believe 100% that Akbar is trying to set her up across the board. We have to recognize and always acknowledge that Tierra Marie is the actual star. She is the reality star, my God. So she is definitely a target for someone to use her. And when you think about Akbar filming her, saying, "Why are you with me then?" and asking specific questions on camera, it looks like that he was intentionally trying to get a certain kind of a footage to avoid or discredit Tierra Marie's case, especially because he knows that he is very charismatic and manipulative, my God, to almost get her to do whatever he wants her to do, as well as his wives, because this is a man who has several wives or several girlfriends or several women who are fighting for him, fighting on his behalf, fighting his side chicks, my God. So he is clearly manipulative as well as convincing and charismatic, my God. So this is why I've said before last week, I think I explained thoroughly the process in Tierra's head. She is stuck on the fact that this person came across very charming, loving, open, honest, sexy, big dick, giving her what she desires and wants, and then come to find out, how do you put, or how do you process in your mind that this amazing person is also this evil, manipulative, horrible person, my God. So him trying to film her on live to clear his name seemed even more messy, my God. Then to have his girlfriend show up, the Hispanic chick, that seems so calculated, my God, because why would this girl know where he and Tierra Marie are, my God? And again, I get it that they're in an open relationship or polygamous situation or polyamorous situation, but for him to tell this girl, knowing she would be aggressive and wanting to fight Tierra Marie, seems like a setup. And then we jump to the wife, I have to put air quotes, the wife showing up to the LA home when she should be in the Texas home to confront Akbar and the girlfriend because of the video that was on live and the girlfriend trying to fight. And one thing I must acknowledge, it was so wrong of the girlfriend to call Tierra Marie alcoholic. I'm confused because they set this all up clearly. So why are they going so hard with trying to attack Tierra Marie, especially when these two women know how their man is, my God? Look, he has y'all acting a fool. So you cannot be coming at Tierra Marie as if she is the one who is causing all the problems and drama. It is your man, my God. It is Akbar's sexy ass, my God. But I will say that it was interesting to see how this situation that Akbar wants to be in really isn't healthy, because his two girls are fighting back and forth, my God. The wife that was supposed to be in Texas, like I said, showed up to the LA home and had to confront Akbar and the girlfriend. And the girlfriend was saying, you know, why are you here? And then the wife was saying, you know, you're not following protocol and she's irrelevant and so on and so forth. And my thing is, this looks like a very unhealthy situation, and why Akbar would be trying to add more women to the picture when he can't keep these two in check, my God, is stupid to me, my God. I'm not sure if they're putting on an act for this show to gain some clout and publicity, because I believe that is why he targeted Tierra Marie, but the girlfriend claims she's protecting all of them. The wife has some insecurities. This is just crazy. Now, really quick, this meetup between Rockstar and Tierra Marie, I feel like the production was trying to drill in our head this fake connection between Tierra and Rockstar, because he repeatedly said in this episode, so many times, my God, it was driving me crazy that he didn't know Tierra, but his childhood friend is her cousin, and that's why he wants to protect her. Now, I will say, it was great to see a better side of Rockstar with trying to protect Tierra Marie, but we also see that this man is an entertainer. He is great for TV, because when he met with Tierra Marie and just was recapping over what possibly happened and how she got caught up, when he said, my God, was he hitting it from behind, asking, you know, are you still going to sue me? When I tell you, that is classic manipulation, my God. A man who knows his dick is good and tries to control a person based off of their dick and sex. But my thing is, I've been in that situation before, but I ain't crazy, I ain't stupid. I don't care how dicky good is, you cannot control me, my God. And clearly Tierra is at a point in her life where she is allowing someone to control her. And I'm glad that at least when Rockstar can be messy like he normally is, he was actually calling Tierra Marie out on her bullshit. He said, you cannot keep going back and then play the victim. And I love that at least in this episode and scene, Tierra Marie was owning her wrongs. She said, yes, Rockstar was talking all crazy and be disrespectful to her and calling her out. But what he said was 100% right. She kept going back, and I gagged that Tierra Marie actually admitted and said that his dick is good. That's why she keeps going back. But my thing is, that is something very cute to say, but it's never about dick being good, because even Rockstar said he has some good dick, but he has never been in this situation before. Next, we must address the Marcus and Brooke conversation, with Marcus telling Brooke about the whole Rockstar Lucci situation and them being upset with him about him running back to A1. Now, I am a tad bit torn on my position in this Brooke versus Marcus and trying to control your partner, because Marcus does not want Brooke to be involved nor work with Rockstar because he's so messy. But it was a tad bit hard because Marcus wants Brooke to not work with Rockstar and said, if you're my woman, I should be able to tell you who not to work with and what not to do, and it should be okay. And I think that comes across very controlling, because you should have to have trust in your spouse. And that is what Brooke's point was. She said, if you're my man, you should be able to trust me, know that I'm going to do the right thing, my God. So I get where Marcus is, because I don't think his position is actually controlling Brooke. He wants to protect their relationship as well as Brooke from all the messiness, my God. But when you think about Brooke being on Love & Hip Hop, not really having released much music in years, she did release a song before, I think, but not much of anything else. And the song that she started to record with Rockstar sounded like a very, very hot song. It worked for her vocals. I feel like it could be everything, my God. So Brooke is in a very hard place where she wants to start singing again, as well as have a hot record. And then now her man doesn't want her to work with Rockstar. So church, please comment down below. Let me know where you stand on this topic. Should Brooke be listening to Marcus because that's her man, her fiance, or should she go with her heart, which is her passion and her music, and get this song done? Because I do believe that Marcus is putting her at like a rock and a hard place, because the song could be good and it could be something great for Brooke. And I know she wants Marcus to marry her. So I don't know. I don't know what I would do in that situation, because a good song is hard to come by, and you never know when something is your passion, what could be your breakthrough in your moment, and to give it up for a man when really your man should be supportive. But Rockstar is so messy, so I'm just so torn, my God. But I did not like that Marcus was so quick to threaten Brooke about calling off the engagement if she does actually continue to work with Rockstar. I feel like that's not something significant enough to say we should not be together. And Brooke did say that Marcus did this to her last season with her trying to work with Booby, my God. But Brooke, you know, your ass was sexually attracted and trying to hump on Booby. So Marcus had every right to not want Brooke and Booby to work together, my God, because I don't think there is any real sexual chemistry or connection between Brooke and Rockstar. So that's why I'm a little bit torn between all of this, my God. Next, let's address Rockstar going to Ray J about having Tierra Marie's back. I thought it was great that Ray J did encourage and support Tierra and spoke positively about her, even though they had some issues in the past with them dating and so on and so forth. But it was great to see that Ray J did confirm that it was a good idea for Rockstar to protect Tierra and have her back against this Akbar dude, my God. Next, that quick moment with Amber Diamond and her mom, and then we found out that Marcus is liking all of Amber's booty pics and they're texting, my God. I am like, are we about to go back into this same cycle? We are rooting for Brooke and Marcus. We want a doggone love and hip hop wedding, my God. So, I hope this is not going to be an issue, and I hope that Amber Diamond takes her mom's advice with not being a side chick again, my God. Then we saw Brooke show up at Rockstar Studio to try to tell him that she was not going to work with him and respect her man, because she also did check Rockstar for bringing Marcus into all the BS and messing up her opportunity to have this song. But although she went there, my God, to not do the song, Rockstar convinced her ass to get in the booth, and it's so hard. I wish she would have just told Marcus that she was still going to do it versus now sneaking and going behind his back. So this is so difficult. But Rockstar knows that he is a character, persuasive, and a clown, because for him to do his best to convince Brooke to get in the studio, my God, then to have her already on his flyer for his album release party, as well as Tierra, and then have his eggplant photo pop up on the projector, my God, although he had on underwear. Rockstar is a mess. I think we have like a love and hate relationship with him. He is so damn messy that it's annoying, but it's very entertaining, my God. Next, let's address AD contacting Fizz behind Monisa's back to get visitation rights to see Cam when AD is not a step-parent nor a parent to Cameron. I'm telling you, I have lost all respect for AD. I am totally on Monisa's side in this whole situation. I am so glad, my God, that Fizz had Monisa's back in this situation. He really protected her. Even though AD snuck and wanted to have a private meeting, Fizz said, no, ma'am. He contacted Monisa, gave her the heads up, had her come over. And I love that Fizz checked AD and said, I've had plenty of exes and none of my exes are still around visiting Cam. So you have to respect his mother. And I was so confused as to why AD felt like she could blame Monisa and this relationship for Cam being hurt about AD not being around, my God. And I feel like that is the lowest of the low to hear AD drag Monisa's son into this, my God. AD, this is your second time dating Monisa. Your ass should have never showed back up to reconcile if you cannot stand being around her. You couldn't stand her last time, so why did you try it again and then get back involved with Cam? So you are just as much responsible for Cam being hurt as you're claiming that Monisa is, my God. Also, I was confused because even AD verified that they were going through therapy, but AD said that their problems are bigger than therapy. But I feel like AD is exposing her own issues. And I love that Monisa was on her P's and Q's because she called AD's ass out every time AD exposed herself, because AD said, I can't stand being around you. There's a part of me that shows up that I don't like. And Monisa was like, that's because it's something that you have to work on. It's about you, my God. And then when AD said, I keep choosing the wrong person, then Monisa clapped back and said, you keep choosing the wrong person. So that means that there's something wrong with you, my God. I said, yes, Moni, you better be locked, loaded, and ready, because that is so true. If you keep choosing the wrong person, just like I know I have in the past, I had to begin working on me. Regardless of what someone else has done to me, granted, I cannot take accountability for their actions, but I can take accountability for what I am doing and what situations I'm putting myself in, as well as the issues inside of me that's allowing me to choose the wrong people, my God. So to CAD deflecting and projecting, my God, and pushing off her issues on Monice, when Monice is the one who is encouraging and concerned about saving the relationship as well as going to therapy, I'm a tad bit confused, because if Monice is concerned about therapy, AD has these issues, it seems like Monice is using therapy. Why is AD not using the therapy properly, my God, or putting the tools that they're learning in therapy to work? So that's why I'm more so prone to believe that AD might be the issue, because why is AD not working on herself in this moment of therapy? Because AD said, well, I'm getting rid of you to work on myself. Bitch, should have done that last time when you broke up with Monice. And I love that Monice was so open and so free to say, Cam and AD, you are my world, but guess what? You will not take me through this again, my God. Next, let's address Rockstar's album release party. So, Rockstar's album release party. I was waiting for the producers to acknowledge that Amber Diamond and Sierra Marie were at odds one particular season, because Amber Diamond was the chick that Cisco was dating while he was dating Sierra Marie, my God. And they made amends and apologized, so it was beautiful to see. They were very mature. But then, Akbar's wife, his women are always showing up. When you are in a polygamous situation, I would expect there to be more trust, the people being more secure in themselves. There is so much insecurity going on for these chicks to be popping up everywhere, my God. But I feel like Tierra Marie owned the moment, because she took accountability for her saying, yes, I wrote his dick. Yes, the dick was good. Yes, I kept going back. I do feel like y'all used me. And the wife said, I would have never choose you, and so on and so forth. But your problem is with your man. And that's what Bridget and Brooke said. Why is she here confronting Tierra Marie and not her man, my God? So I feel like that this wife is making herself look stupid. I love that Tierra Marie explained that this man said he wasn't married. I'm saying you're not married because a marriage is public record. So where's your marriage license, my guy? So I'm wondering if Tia Marie just exposed that Akbar and his wife are not really married. They're just claiming to be married, my guy. And Sierra did say in this moment that she is done with Akbar. She is not going back. I do pray and hope that she is done, but I do know the struggle when somebody has that power of charisma, and then they're sexy, and then you're alone, and so on and so forth. I do know how difficult it can be for a Tierra Marie, my God. Next, Tierra Marie did meet with her attorney. He called her out as well for going back to Akbar, especially the live video that was released. The attorneys are concerned. They don't want to give Tierra Marie no more chances. They said no more second chances. Tierra Marie did say that Akbar set her up. She was on her way to the airport when he called her, and that's how the girlfriend got involved, and he was trying to, I guess, have footage to prove that she is still trying to see him when she really wasn't, but she actually really is, because she's still having sex with him, my God. So it's so confusing. And one thing I will say, as much as I want to defend Tierra Marie and all this, because I understand being used, manipulated, and then falling in love with the manipulator, my God, or the opportunist, I don't believe that she was on her way to the airport, because she said she was on her way to the airport when Akbar called her. Tierra Marie, you look like you just got finished getting some dick, because your hair was all over the place. You look disheveled. You had sex all over you, and you don't look like you're going to the airport when you're dressed from having sex, my God. So I don't believe she was going to the airport. I do think she was set up. I do think she agreed to get some dick, but I was confused how the airport came into play, because I know that she would show up to the airport looking a lot better than she was looking in that moment, my God. I also was so proud, and I believe this showed some growth on Tierra Marie's part, when she spoke and acknowledged that it's not really about Akbar's dick, because this whole episode she kept saying, his dick is good, his dick is good, his dick is good, building up this Negro's head, blowing up his head, my God. But she said, it's not really his dick. I've been saying it. It's the way he speaks to me. And I know firsthand how that feels when when someone makes you feel good, when many people have not made you feel that way, and you feel like they're uplifting you, supporting you, they're your backbone, and it's something that you've never had before. I know what she means, my God, so I do feel bad for her. My heart goes out to her, and I'm glad she said it's not the dick. It's how he makes me feel. It's how he talks to me. He can get me to do almost anything, my God, almost, my God, but we all have our damn breaking point, and the reality of it is she's suffering from or battling alcoholism. I've battled depression, but guess what? At the end of the day, I was depressed, but I'm not stupid, my God. Last but not least, the scene with Akbar and Rockstar. Rockstar tried to confront Akbar in this fake fight that we all knew wasn't going to happen. It was such a fake scene to me, but it did stick out to me how happy that Akbar is because he called himself a low-key porn star. So again, I feel like if you actually pay attention, people who are manipulative or users or opportunists always say little teeny-weeny things that exposes who they really are. And for him to not have put out the sex tape, but then you're happy about getting the publicity from the sex tape to where you would call yourself a porn star and celebrate how big your dick is and it's so long and so on and so forth, which it might be, my God. Akbar probably has some good dick. I don't doubt it. Like I said, I'll probably be the one in Sierra Marie's position. Not as stupid, because you can't use me that much to where it's just blatant. Because at this point, Akbar really isn't even hiding that he's using her. But again, that whole moment between Rockstar and Akbar was so silly. But Akbar was so happy to be getting extra camera time. I do feel like that Rockstar was defending Tierra Marie. He was actually concerned in the moment that he was also being silly. But that's about it, guys. Please follow me on all social media outlets. Thumbs up this video. Subscribe to my channel. Turn on the notifications, share this video, and thank you guys for tuning in. Bye, guys.